issues that I didn't really even know about. And they, you know, I just went south and went
I'm really involved in that. to develop this program for half a year. They offered nice residency, the work, studio, piano for me at the Cité Internationale des Arts. And so that was actually a very French-inspired program where when I actually realized I developed synesthesia, as many of you know, Messiaen and a lot of other Scriabin, but I didn't expect that I would actually have it, but I guess I sort of developed it, or I had it before and I didn't realize till then. And so you will see today there are two paintings of mine. One will be one watercolor piece that is matching the fireworks of Debussy's Prelude, Last Prelude. And then the other one is a rather new work but with colors and resin. That's how I was inspired to hear the Messiaen piece. So, and today's program will be broken into three sets. So, four Debussy pieces, and then we'll have a pause where I talk more about Ravel and Messiaen, and then the last set, which is really truly wonderful, audio-visual set that is more with cutting-edge technology and the Interscopo, and we'll have our wonderful composer from Stanford, Jarek Kapuscinski, talk about that before that set. So please hold your applause between each set, and we will start.
Thank you.
painting. But maybe, hopefully, you'll get a glimpse of what I just played. So yeah, rewind. Well, I will go on to the next set, just talking about the next set. Oh, here. Here's the painting. But it's too bright to see it, I guess. So this is when I was inspired by the last piece when you heard, and all of a sudden I just saw all the colors and watched the bright colors and lighting and everything just coming at me. So I really didn't spend much time practicing the piece than painting. I mean, that was the beginning. Later I practiced the piece. So that's that. Now let's move on to the next one, the next set. So it's a lot darker for me. I don't have paintings for you yet for the Ravel set. So this is a 1 minute homage à Ravel by a living French composer, Frédéric Duhier, who's also a professor at the Paris Conservatoire. And so he wrote this homage à Ravel, and I paired it with Ravel, Oiseau Triste. And for me, the colors are a lot more sombre, a lot darker. So you'll sense it yourself, I suppose. And I'm curious how all of you here, you know, see different colors. And then I will continue right away to this gigantic Messiaen piece. For me, it's almost like a rock piece. I love playing it because I feel like it turns me into a rock star. At least closest to that. And I recently did this painting, so I suppose Yerrick, you'll play it when I start the Messiaen piece. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. I guess Jenny asked me just to say a couple of words about the two pieces, two little journeys that we're taking you on together. The first one, calligraphy is for Zichi. I should say calligraphy is for Jenny. because it was inspired by the fabulous Chinese calligraphy in this cursive version and the wonderful calligrapher in Shanghai, Shangcheng Zhao, that through Jenny and some friends in Shanghai we got introduced to. And as we explore that actually together with Jenny, looking really closely at the gestural information, at the expression of calligraphy, discovering how much it is close to music and dance and so on, we also found this very interesting story about the friendship, another friendship, a musical friendship of a composer and of a performer and listener. When the listener suddenly dies, the performer decides to destroy his instrument because there's only one that could listen that well. So that's a very, very old, special story from ancient China. And so you will see in this piece some of the words from that story woven into the piece, and you will see the titles of the calligraphies that you'll be able to see. And what's really interesting about this, I hope for you as well, is that Jenny will be in control of that flow. Because there are actually two microphones hidden in the piano there, and these microphones send the signal to the computer. And in the computer, the score of the piece is pre-recorded, it's present there, and the computer is listening to what Jenny's doing and following her. So this way, she can in some ways redraw the calligraphies as she goes. The computer is trying to play with her, tries to be intelligent in it, a little bit like in chamber music, playing its part being those calligraphies. So that's the first journey. The second journey is, the title is Side Effects, and that's in this whole program of brushes, mm-hmm. and painterly ideas. It started for me when I discovered photographs of Kacper Kowalski, who is the author of the video. I looked at it and I felt, wow, this is how I guess we as human beings paint our world. And you'll see he's an aerial photographer, so what you will see is the world from above. And that's transformed by us. It's repainted. It's touched by us in different ways. Sometimes disturbing, sometimes not. So when I saw this, I also felt, well, this is like music. It's so beautifully composed. And then having also Jenny in mind and her wonderful world of emotions and. You've seen it. I don't need to tell you. It's very impressive. So both of these pieces, in some ways, are meant for Jenny, and so they will be also played without interruption. So one attaka into the other. Did I say everything we needed to?
I think I had enough of a break.
Okay, we will change some lighting situation here. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, thank
okay.
you. Totally unexpected. Okay.
Yeah, I know.
So, anyway, I'm not a director of CNMAT, I'm just a professor here,
okay.
So the director is Ed Campion, but he's in
So,
but thank you very much for this surprise. So this piece is called Expectations, and it's a piece that was composed to be played between two Beethoven's pieces. So basically, I didn't know what to play. When you know the pianist had played Beethoven before and after, so I decided not to play anything. And so it's based on resonances that you can do with the piano without playing too much, too many notes, let's say that. And so, thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you.